Hello and welcome to Mike Academy. So in this video, we're going to be looking at numerical differentiation in numerical analysis using the backward difference formula. To get the full package on numerical differentiation so far, do well to look at the playlist of this video and you'll get links to amazing videos that have been made on numerical differentiation. Now in this video, we're going to be solving two examples to explain the backward difference formula. Now let's consider this question on the board. It says, compute the first, second, and third derivative when x is equal to 8. So like I've said in all my videos, an understanding of which of the part of the table the value you're to approximate falls is a key to understanding numerical differentiation. In this case, we are told to differentiate when x is equal to 8. And if we look at this table, excluding the table that contains x and y, and let's consider the tables with real values. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this table can be broken into 5, which means the first two, we can dissect this into the first two, the last two, and then we have the midpoint. So the first two simply means the forward table, the last two here simply means the backward table, and then the center here simply means the central table. So any value we are to approximate, if it falls in the forward table, then it means we are going to be using the Newton's forward difference method to solve the problem. If it falls in the center of the table, it means we are going to be using the central difference method to solve. But if the value falls at the back of the table, it means we are going to be using the backward difference method to solve. In this case, we are told to approximate when x is equal to 8. And you see that 8 starts from the back of the table. So which means we are going to be using what? The backward difference method to approximate that derivative. So let's start with the first derivative. For the first derivative, the y all over the x, the formula is simply f of x minus h all over h squared. And you have this. So which means we need to find our h and we need to find everything that makes up this formula. Where h is simply what? A step size or the interval. So h simply means the difference between successive values of x, which can be x2 minus x1, or it can be x3 minus x2, and so on. So the second value of x here, x2 here is 4. So you have 4 minus x1 is 2. So this simply implies that our interval h is equal to 2. 4 minus 2 remains 2. Now from the formula, we need to find f of x. So we simply compute f of x. Now f of x simply means the value of the function at the point of interest. The point of interest is x equals 8. So f of x simply means f of 8. So this simply means when x is 8, what is the value of y, or what is f of x? So you look at the table, this is 8. X here is 8, and when x is 8, the value of y is simply 20. So it means f of 8 equals 20. The next thing to do is to find f of x minus h. That's going to be equal to f of x remains 8, the point of interest, minus, we obtain h now to be equal to 2. So minus 2. So this is actually what? F of 6. So you look at the table. When x is 6, what's the value of the function? When x is 6, f of x is simply 15. So it means f of 6 equals 15. So this simply means f of x minus h is equal to 15. So let's couple that into the first derivative formula. This is now going to be equal to f of x itself. We obtain f of x to be equal to 20. So you simply have 20 minus f of x minus h. That gives us 15 divides by h. Sorry, please, this is divide by h and not h squared, please. That is simply h and not h squared. So divide by h, and h itself is, h is 2. So this is actually 5 divided by 2. So which implies that the first derivative is simply 2.5. So when x is equal to, when x is equal to 8, the first derivative is simply 2.5. All right, for the second derivative approximation, the squared y all over the x squared is going to now be equal to, so you have f of x minus 2f of x minus h plus f of x minus 2h. The whole of this divides by h squared. Okay, so from the formula, we already know what f of x is. We know what f of x minus h is. Let us now find f of x minus 2h. So we simply compute f of x minus h. This is going to be equal to f of x is the point of interest, which is 8 minus 2 times h is 2. So that's going to be f of 2 times 2 is 4. So you have 8 minus 4 to be 4. So that gives you f of 4. And if you look at the table, when x is equal to 4, f of x is simply 10. So f of 4 equals 10. Now let's plug all of this value into the formula. So we're going to have the squared y all over the x squared to be equal to f of x. Remember, f of x is simply 20. So you plug it 20 minus 2 times f of x minus h. That simply gives us 15. So minus 15, okay, plus f of x minus 2h, and that gave us 10. Okay, we have that to be 10. So plus 10 divided by h is 2 all squared. So this is going to be equal to, okay, let me evaluate everything at the numerator just to save time. 2 times 15 is 30. So 20 minus 30 is actually negative 10 plus 10. That's 0 divided by 4. 0 divided by 4. So this simply implies that the double derivative, the squared y all over the x squared, is equal to 0 using the backward difference method. Okay. And next we find the third derivative approximation. So for the third derivative, the cube y all over the x cube is equal to, you have f of x minus 3 f of x minus h plus 3 f of x minus 2 h minus f of x minus 3 h, all divided by h to the power of 3. Okay, so we have every other formula here. We have x minus h, we have x minus 2h, we are looking for now x minus f of x minus 3h. So let's find f of x minus 3h. This is going to be f of x is 8 minus 3 times h is 2. So this is going to be f of, so 3 times 2 is 6, 8 minus 6 is simply 2. So we simply find f of 2. And this is going to be equal to, so you look through the table, when x is 2, the value of f of x is 5. So f of 2 is simply 5, and you have this. So let's compute into the formula and obtain our results. So the cube y all over the x cube is going to be equal to f of x is 20 minus 3, f of x minus h, that gave us 15. Plus 3, f of x minus 2h, that gave us 10. Okay. Minus f of x minus 3h, and we just obtain the value now as 5. So the whole of this divided by h cubed, which is 2 to the power of 3. Okay. So let's evaluate everything at the numerator. So you're going to have 3 times 15 is 45, 20 minus 45, that's negative 25, plus 3 times 10 is 30, so negative 25 plus 30 gives us 5, 5 minus 5 is simply 0, so everything at numerator once again is 0 divided by 2 squared is 8, and that simply means that the third derivative, the cube y all over the x cube, is actually equal to 0. Okay. So you have this value to be equal to 0. All right, let's now dive straight into the next and final question for this particular video. All right, so let's consider the last question for this video. The question says, compute the second and third derivative when x is 1.85. And you already know 1.85 lies at the back of the table. So since it's at the back of the table, it simply means we are going to be using the Newton backward difference formula to approximate that derivative, which is the essence of this video. So for the second derivative approximation, this is the formula. Of course, you already know this. So the next thing for us to do is to find the interval h. So our interval h is simply equal to, remember, x2 minus x1. It can also be x3 minus x2 and so on. So x2 here is 1.45, x1 here is 1.25, so minus 1.25. So this value is simply going to be 0.2. So our interval is simply 0.2. Okay, so having found 0.2, the next thing is to compute f of x, f of x minus h, and f of x minus 2h. So let's start with f of x. F of x simply means f x that means the point of interest, which is 1.85. So that is simply one f of 1.85. So this simply means when x is 1.85, what is the value of f of x? So when x is 1.85, f of x here is 25.0. So we'll simply pick it out, 25.0. Next, we'll find f of x minus h. This is going to be f of x is 1.85 minus h, there is the interval, which is 0.2. So this is going to be equal to f of 1.85 minus 0.2 should be 1.65. So you have f of 1.65. So you look at the table, this means when x is 1.65, what is the value of f of x? F of x when x is 1.65 is simply 14.735. So it means we have that to be 14.735. That becomes our f of x minus h. Finally, we compute f of x minus 2h. This is going to be equal to f of x is 1.85 minus 2h is 2 times 0.2. So this is going to be equal to f of 2 times 0.2 is 0.4. So 1.85 minus 0.4, that should give us 1.45. Okay, so we find f of 1.45. f of 1.45. This simply means when x is 1.45, what is f of x? The value here is 8.0. So f of x is simply f of x minus f of 1.545 is simply 8.0. Sorry. Okay. So f of 1.45 is simply 8.0. So let's plug all the values we've gotten now into the formula, right? So we find the squared y all over the x squared. This is going to be equal to f of x. And we had f of x to be equal to 25. So you have 25 minus 2 times f of x minus h. We had f of x minus h to be equal to 14.375, right? 14.735. So please, this is 14.735 and not 14.375. So 14.735 from the table, please. Okay. 14.735. Okay. Plus f of x minus 2h. And we had f of x minus 2h as 8. So plus 8. Divide this by h squared. H is 0.2 all squared. So I will evaluate everything at the numerator all at once just to save time. Do well to point along with me to avoid calculation errors. So everything at the numerator gives me 3.53 divides by, let's now obtain 0.2 to the power of 2. That simply gives us 0.04. So let's find this ratio, 3.53 divided 0.04. That gives us 88.25. So this becomes the second derivative approximation of that given function when x is equal to 1.85. Okay, the next thing we should find the third derivative approximation. So remember the formula, the cube y all over the x cube is simply equal to, you have f of x minus 3 f of x minus h plus 3 f of x minus 2h minus f of x minus 3h. The whole of this divides by h cube. Okay, so I think we have everything in the formula except for f of x minus 3h. So let's compute f of x minus 3h. So f of x minus 3h is simply equal to f of x itself, you know, is 1.85 minus 3 times 0.2. So this is going to be equal to f of, so let's compute 3 times 0.2 is 0.6. so 1.85 minus 0.6, that should give us 1.25, right? That should give us 1.25. So this becomes f of 1.25. So it means now that we are looking for our f of x minus 3h is equivalent to f of 1.25. So you look from the table, when x is 1.25, what is f of x? The value is simply 4.475. So you have 4.475. All right, so let's plug now into the derivative formula. That means the cube y all over the x cube is going to now be equal to, so f of x again is 20 minus 3 into f of x minus h. The f of x minus h is simply 14.735. So you have 14.735 plus 3 into f of x minus 2h. And f of x minus 2h simply gave us 8 minus f of x minus 3h, which just obtained now as 4.475. So minus 4.475. The whole of this divides by h cube, which is 0.2 to the power of 3. So the cube y all over the x cube is now going to be, so I'll point everything once again at the numerator. So let's evaluate all together and see. And so sorry guys, this was supposed to be 25. F of x is not 20, but rather 25. Sorry about that. I'm so sorry. Okay, so let's evaluate now. So everything our numerator gave us 0.32 divided by 0.2 to the power of 3. That simply gives us 0.008. Okay, so let's find 0.32 divided by 0.008. So it means the cube y over the x cube is simply 40. All right, so the result of that derivative is simply 40 for the third derivative. All right guys, so that's how you employ the backward difference formula to solve numerical differentiation in numerical analysis. So I have just one question for you as an assignment. You play around with it and share the answers via the comment section or via my WhatsApp number up there. Alright guys, so try to lay your hands on this question. Try to approximate the first, second and third derivative when x is 1.87. Tell me your experience or what you noticed while doing this. Share your answer or your experience in the comment section or let's have a chat on my WhatsApp number displayed up there. In the next class, we're going to be looking at the central difference method of numerical differentiation in numerical analysis. I hope to see you in that video. Stay blessed. Cheers.